It is my fervent hope that Britain will join the other countries of the Commonwealth and impose sanctions on an apartheid regime that has no place in the modern world.
Let us be quite clear about this. Nothing useful can be achieved by sanctions.
Really? It was my understanding they would devastate the South African government.
Well, they would devastate us too. Trade between our two countries is worth £3 billion a year.
I thought we might look at it from the South African point of view.
I am, ma'am. South Africa is already a disinvestment economy.
But black South Africans want sanctions, so shouldn't we listen to them?
Well, black South Africans don't want to inherit a wasteland.
They will if they feel it is their wasteland.
There are ways of Britain being great again. And that is through a revitalized economy, not through association with unreliable tribal leaders in eccentric costumes.
But isn't that all I am, Prime Minister? A tribal leader in eccentric costumes?
Certainly not. You're head of an evolved constitutional monarchy that stretches back to William the Conqueror. It's not comparing like with like.
Ah, now that's where we differ. You see, I consider myself to be exactly like them. To me, Ghana, Zambia, Malawi are all great sovereign nations with great histories. I am aware you probably don't share that view. To you, the Commonwealth is something of a distraction, a waste of time. But in many ways, I have given my life to it.
But we cannot let the values of the past distract us from the realities of the present, particularly where Britain's economic interests are concerned.
48 countries of the Commonwealth are now preparing a statement condemning the South African regime and recommending tougher sanctions. What I would like you to do is sign that statement.
She rejected any mention of proposals.
I'm determined to win this battle, Sonny. I don't often get into a fight, but when I do, I want to win.
Measures. No, no, no. No. Sorry.
A no to measures.
Yes, so we are going back with actions.
And should that fail?
We still have controls.
Yes, I'm beginning to see this is all about control.
No. 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 They must be out of their minds. No. No. No.
Signals?
Yes. She agreed to signals. And among the signals she agreed to are actually several of the sanctions she would never have contemplated had they been called sanctions.
Oh, thank you, Michael.
Prime Minister.
Yes.
You have been forced to make significant concessions.
Not that I noticed.
You signed a document prepared by 48 countries who were in conflict with you.
I did. But the question is, did one person move to the 48? Or did 48 move to one? Yes, I agreed to signals. But as you know, with one simple turn, a signal can soon point in an entirely different direction. Thank you.
That's what she said?
Yes, ma'am. Before walking off.
Really? But what if I'm not happy with the job she's been doing? What if on this occasion I'd be happy for people to know the displeasure was actually real? That I am personally concerned about her lack of compassion. You know how seriously I take my constitutional responsibility to remain silent, but each of us has our line in the sand. And if it were to become public knowledge that there had been an unprecedented rift between Sovereign and Prime Minister, would that really be so bad?
If that really were your intention, and for the record, ma'am, I must say, I think that would be a misjudgment and risk doing serious and irreparable harm to the relationship between Buckingham Palace and Downing Street. today would not be the newspaper I would go to. I'd go somewhere with more heft, somewhere that also had a clear sense of the unprecedented nature of this, where they understood the rules of the game.
Right, well, can I leave that with you then, Michael? You are the expert.
Ma'am.
A constitutional crisis was on the verge of erupting this morning as the Sunday Times published details of a sensational rift between Buckingham Palace and Downing Street. This story, which is likely to have a serious impact on what have traditionally been cordial relations between the sovereign and her prime ministers, cites the cause of the rift as an alleged dispute over Mrs. Thatcher's failure to commit to a policy of sanctions against apartheid in South Africa.
Nice.
A position regarding which the Queen has apparently expressed her disapproval, marking a distinct break with the monarch's long-held practice of never passing comment on political affairs. So far, Buckingham Palace has refused to be drawn on the veracity of the report. The palace spokesman declining to comment.
The African Queen at odds with number 10. It has been an eventful week for Buckingham Palace. Queen Elizabeth II, a well-intentioned apolitical figurehead, has been dragged into a messy row over South Africa because of the stubbornness and insensitivity
of her prime minister. Far from being a straightforward, uncomplicated countrywoman,
a late middle-aged grandmother who is most at ease when talking about dogs and horses,
she's shown that she's also an astute political infighter who is quite prepared to take on Downing Street
when provoked.
Really? Uncaring, confrontational, and socially divisive. That's how these sources so close to the Queen describe me.
Prime Minister.
That I lack compassion, and that my government has done irretrievable damage to the country's social fabric. My goal is to change this country from being dependent to self-reliant, and I think in that I am succeeding.
I have had to learn many difficult lessons as sovereign.
Britons are learning to look after number one, to get ahead, and only then, if they choose, to look after their neighbor.
Of those?
No one would remember the Good Samaritan if he only had good intentions. You see, he had money as well.
Perhaps the hardest is that I am obliged to support my prime ministers on any position they take, even yours, regarding sanctions against South Africa. My question is, given the lack of impact it has on your day-to-day political fortunes, yet how important it is to me, could you not have supported me just once? My fellow Commonwealth leaders, many of whom I consider to be friends, now feel that I have betrayed them on an issue most important to them.
One unfortunate consequence of our denial of the story is that the editor of the Sunday Times has now come out all guns blazing, and whilst we could continue to deny it, my own view is that it's no longer to our advantage. And I think we're now going to have to give them something.
What?
A culprit. To deflect blame from you and to put these flames out ASAP. We need to let them have a name.
Michael.
I was shocked by the way in which you were forced to leave office. And I wanted to offer my sympathy, not just as Queen to Prime Minister, but woman to woman. The Order of Merit is not awarded by some faceless committee. It comes at the personal discretion of the sovereign and is in recognition of exceptionally meritorious service. It is limited to just 24 recipients, no matter their background. What matters is your accomplishments. And nobody can deny that this is a very different country now to the one inherited by our first woman Prime Minister.